Welcome to Let's Go Live Writing Sprints. I am so behind again today. I was like, I'm gonna be super motivated. I'm gonna wake up early, start my new life. And I was like, I'm gonna go for a 2.5 mile walk this morning, which I did. However, it made me really late. So I ran into a couple neighbors, chit-chatted with them. It's like 80 degrees out. It is so hot. It's like 1,000% humidity. So I had sweat everywhere. So my hair is like still drying and the makeup is still, I think I'm still sweating from walking. Isn't that always like that where like your exercise, I don't know, you're still sweating. So anyway, but I did beat out the lawn crew. You can probably hear them a little bit in the background, but when I walked around the corner, okay, see, no, that's too low. Like a crotch shot. Oh. Okay. I think we got it this time. Anyway, so happy Saturday. All that to mean. Happy Saturday. This is the last Saturday of October. And I don't know. I think you guys, if you've joined me on Saturdays before, you know that I'm participating in NaNoWriMo. So if you're participating in NaNo, let's be buddies. You can find me on NaNoWriMo at GiGi Meier. Pretty easy. I already have my book loaded in there that I want to work on. And I don't know if I upload the cover or not. I hope not, because I haven't done the cover reveal either. Ooh. Anyway, that being said, I think I'm gonna try to aim for like 60,000 words on NaNo. I did that in July for camp. I did it last year when I was writing Takahashi in November. So I feel like I can do it if I buckle down, but I don't know. I'm pretty excited about the book I'm finishing up this week. I absolutely am supposed to have it done by the end of the month, which is Tuesday. And I need to write basically 20,000 words in the next, I don't know, 4 days, including today, in order to meet my deadline and have it over to my dev editor. So I don't know if that's gonna happen. Good morning. You're so sweet. She's like, it's definitely gonna happen. So that's, thank you for the good vibes. So anyway, I'd love to hear what you guys are working on, what your writing projects are, what you wanna achieve in the next like 2 months. I heard a podcast, I guess it was yesterday, and I was kind of finishing up listening to it today, and they were talking about future casting, and I was like, I've never heard those two words together, so let me look up what that means. And so there's not a whole lot on it, you know, when I went out to like YouTube and Google, but it's mainly like future casting for businesses, not forecasting, but kind of similar. But how you can do that for yourself personally. And so it was fascinating because basically what my interpretation of it is that it is taking your future self that you want. So like, let's say we got 2 months left in this year. What do you want to achieve? Because the time is going to pass regardless. So what do you want to achieve by the end of the year? What would make you most proud? It could be like a weight loss goal or a gain, you know, if you want to gain muscle or if you want to lose fat. It could be like a lifestyle change. It's like, I should really give up Diet Coke because it's really not great for you. That's a whole nother conversation. healthy eating, giving up something, adding something like more vegetables or more fruit in your diet. Or it could be like, for me, I want to really have 2 books written. I want to have Sebastian. I also want to have Giovanni. And then I also want to have, well, I guess it's 60,000 words in Isla's book. So that's actually like 2 different series, and I would like to have 2.5 books written. And is that achievable in the next 2 months? And so you set whatever your goal is for the end of the year. You're like, okay, what does this version of my life look like at the end of the year? You know, am I happier? Am I healthier? Am I wealthier? You name it, right? So you pick your goal, which is the future casting of yourself. What do you look like? And then you break down, so like your current and then your past, and then there's the middle that you break down, and you're like, okay, how do I make that future, the end of the year, what do I do for the next 60 days in order to become as close to that person as possible? So anyway, that's what I was came across yesterday, was thinking about last night when I went to the football game with my bestie. And then this morning on my walk. So anyway, all that goodness to bring to you guys. So all that to be said, I'm gonna start writing on Sebastian. Like I told you, I have literally 20,000 words I have to write. So that's kind of a lot. And I'm in the middle of a sex scene. And I know I was on here a couple Saturdays ago writing a sex scene. So I don't know, maybe it should be like sex scene Saturday. Nah, I'm kidding. Maybe. I don't know if I'm kidding. Okay, I need to keep that one plugged in. You know, if I was more organized, I'd have all this stuff done before I got on here with y'all. Okay. You can tell my allergies are bothering me, and it always happens. We're supposed to have like a humongous temperature drop, I think tomorrow, which, yes, finally, because, you know, like I said, it's so hot and humid, and it's almost November. But I think it's supposed to drop like 30 degrees, so be in the 50s. And so I am so ready for it. Bulldog's ready for it, because then he can walk farther. What am I doing? Okay. So I'm going to put 25 minutes up, and then we are going to get started. Good morning. Good morning. Oh, my message is just coming in. Yeah, so you're working on it too. Good. I know, you're so supportive. Oh, it's in the 20s where you're at already? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, we don't need to go in the 20s. I'm a fair weather girl, not an all weather girl. So anyway, I hope that's working. Okay, so I'm gonna put 25 minutes up and then we will get to writing. Okay. I'll see that. Great. And I'm gonna mute my line because I have a bulldog who likes to walk in here. And then that way y'all also don't have to hear him, so. Okay, good morning. Okay, so we will get started. I wish you guys good luck on whatever writing or editing or just author-related stuff that you're working on this morning. And then maybe on our next chat, our next break, we can chat about what y'all are working on. Because I think I feel like I talk about what I work on all the time, and I already know what I'm working on. I want to hear what y'all are working on. Sorry, my hair is still wet and lumpy bumpy. Anyway, okay, so 25 minutes. Y'all see, Okay, y'all see that, kind of, hopefully. All right, let's get started. Go and mute. Hello. Okay, sorry, I didn't. Hope you guys were able to get down some words or editing or whatever your project that you're working on. Geez, my allergies have gotten so bad. Have a cough drop in, hopefully that'll help. And then I have my water. But anyway, I don't know if you noticed, but I had switched over to dictation because I just felt like my writing was going so slow and I was making so many writing mistakes. I was just like, ugh, just get to talking, which one is faster, two, I can communicate my thoughts, obviously. And then I'm not slowed down by like my typing and my errors and all the little red squigglies that happen. Although when I dictate, I should tell you, I end up with more red squigglies because if you don't properly enunciate the words, it'll put in like, what it thinks it is. And then sometimes when I go back and reread it, if I'm not paying attention, because a lot of times when I'm doing this, when I dictate, I will like look out the window and think about the scene in my mind. And am I putting in enough description? Am I putting in enough dialogue? And so when I'm thinking about that, I don't watch the screen. And so that's when I get all these like crazy words. And when I go back and reread it, like later that day or the next day, I'm like, what in the world was I even trying to say? So, geez, sorry guys. So anyway, that's kind of the danger of dictating if you don't enunciate your words like your mama always told you, or at least my mama always said. So anyway, I will see. Typically, I can talk faster, but I was kind of stuck. I was trying to type, messed it all up. So I think I only got like 496 words in that 25-minute writing sprint. So that's not bad. Obviously, I'll take it. But sometimes when I'm really in the zone with dictation, oh geez, I can easily get like 2,000 words in. Well, if I'm really in the zone, which like dialogue and banter, that's easy to do. I mean, I feel like when you have a conversation, it really just, adds to your word count. So I could probably do like 2,000 words in about 30, 35 minutes if it's dialogue. But if it's like inner thoughts or turmoil or conflict, obviously that takes longer, so it's less words. So anyway, and this is kind of my transition because I have like a sex scene. Excuse me. I'm in a transition period because a transition spot right now because I have like a sex scene. And then they're, leaving that sex scene to like, have a break, and then it'll lead into another sex scene. So, I'm riding the break right now, but I'll probably get into that other sex scene pretty quickly because obviously that's romance. That's what you guys want to hear or read. Get all spicy. So, anyway, what was I gonna say? Oh, today I can't be on too long. I was thinking we could do like 2 25-minute writing sprints. Sometimes I go, 3, or one time I even went 4 writing sprints. It was almost 2 hours. But I can't today because it is my baby boy's birthday, and he'll die if you hear me call him baby boy. That's what we used to call him when he was little, obviously. But he's turning 15 today, so we have some things to do, and I have a couple. I don't usually give like gifts anymore because they won't tell me what they want. They just want to have the money to go shopping with their friends or their bros. So anyway, I have to go by and get him his birthday money, and then we're going out to dinner. I don't even know where. He hasn't decided yet. So anyway, so today is all about celebrating his birthday. He's literally still in bed, so that's why I was able to jump on here and spend some time with you guys. So anyway, happy birthday to him. So let's go ahead and do another 25 minutes, and good luck on whatever you guys are working on. I definitely am going to be on mute because I'm going to continue dictating through this scene to get it done. So that way, when I come back, I can then write my sex scene. And those, thank you. That's a sweet happy birthday. Yes. I can come back and write that sex scene, because those always take a lot of time, at least for me, because you have to figure out like where are their hands and where are their tongue and all the logistics of the scene. So anyway, good luck. 25 minutes. I will start it now. All right, and now mute me. Righty, that is 25 minutes. That kind of went fast for me, but I was struggling. I don't know why. Not struggling with the dictation. That went well, much better. But just kind of struggling with like what direction I want this particular scene to go because I need to get her upstairs with him, you know, so that way it's a precursor into the next sex scene. But I also wanted to like throw a wrench in it where they have to, you know, hang out with Gio because he's still there from being sick from the Christmas party. So anyway, it all makes sense when you read it. So I got like 661 words, so a little bit better with the dictation, but then I was getting stuck in my own story. So, and I think that's common, right? Like as authors, you know, we have to think about the direction we want to go. We have to be able to make some decisions and then, you know, write. And I'm trying to match my beat sheet to do a better job, you know, because I'm a 100% pantser, but I'm trying not to pants and I'm trying to plot for a better book overall. But anyway, I hope that this helps hanging out with me on Saturdays. I love hanging out with you guys. It holds me accountable. I like to hear what you guys have going on, what you're writing. Like I said, I already know what I'm writing, I'm doing, so that kind of gets a little lonely when I just have myself and my works to think about. So anyway, thank you for hanging out with me, and I'll be here again next Saturday, so hopefully you will be too. All right, so happy writing and ciao for now.